Just look at the shoulders of Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali's dropping his stance, not lowering that center of gravity. Leandro Ataides told me he wants to take this fight on his feet for the first couple minutes, but look at this, Muhammad Ali is initiating the ground game. There's no fear coming out of Muhammad Ali to attack the ground of Ataides.
Stupendous start, wasn't it? Caught the leg and then just went full pelt. Good candidate for the Javelin fight of the night. There'll be a few candidates by the time we're done, I can assure you of that.
Ataides is nice and relaxed, keeping that head moving. I like how he's keeping his guard a little bit higher this time. Muhammad Ali's getting nice and square, nice and tight, ready to let these punches go in a hurry. Muhammad Ali knows how important this is. Both these guys have been on a losing skid, but they are really trying to up their game and get back to their winning ways here tonight in Manila.
Oh, good left jab from Ataides.
The middleweight division is a highly contested division here at one, and both these guys would like to get a title shot.
What a nice left jab that was from Muhammad Ali.
Ataides might be a little bit of surprised by the aggression shown by Muhammad Ali.
Yeah. Does he normally fight open mouth like that, Mitch? Because he just took a clubbing jab on the mouth. I wonder if he's injured himself slightly.
I think it's just a sort of a relaxed sort of guard. Maybe his mouth guard's a little bit too big, but it's not a good idea to keep your mouth open. But both fighters do have that kind of going on. You want to keep your mouth nice and tight so it really limits the ability for your jaw to move. It can, you know, hurt a little bit in the knockout area if your jaw's hanging wide open. That put you to sleep a bit faster.
Left hook from Muhammad Ali landed as he went skipping inwards, just adding some momentum, some power to the punch. Tries it again there, just short that time, followed it up with a right hand. Ataides had seen it once before and was wise to the trick.
Ataides seems to be content keeping this fight on his feet. Not really in a rush to get this fight to the ground. He just prefers to put on a show, and he thinks striking is something we haven't seen the best of yet. He really wants to showcase that skill, how hard he's been working at it.
We've seen Superman punches many times before. That was a Superman jab followed by a Superman right hand. A two-punch Superman combination.
It's a great way to cover distance. Good feints by Ataides, just really trying to get us a reaction or some kind of just flinch out of Muhammad Ali. And his flinch this time was a spinning back fist.
Yeah.
That came up about 4 feet short, but he still threw it.
It was short. It's a difficult punch to land because it's so heavily telegraphed. Edward Falayang, probably the best exponent thereof.
But it's better in the middle of an exchange.
Oh, good left hand from Muhammad Ali. Threw a right that was short, the left landed flush. We've seen a good number of punches land flush, and these are heavy, heavy hitters. Just squatting down, isn't he, Ali? Making himself shorter than he actually is. Left hook comes in with some pace. Got his right hand up nice and high there, Ali, to block that left hook from Ataides.
Nice leg kick.
Fascinating naked boxing leg kick. Chess match at the moment.
Didn't really put anything behind it, no punches, but just a naked leg kick, and it landed.
We're seeing some expert left hooks from both men.
But Ataides is true by his word. He told me all this week that he wants to keep the first round on his feet and just kind of feel out the process, see what Muhammad Ali's got on his feet. And in the second round, he looks to take it to the ground. But as I say that, he shoots in for the double leg takedown.
Goes for it ahead of time.
He's got to make some work a little bit faster here because he's only got 40 seconds left in the first round. Muhammad Ali's just kind of buying some time with the double overhooks. And I think that's going to add a little bit of an impression in the judges, just to score some points and maybe shift that round to his favor just slightly. You can see Muhammad Ali is holding on for dear life, not wanting to let those arms go. Trying to get back up. He gets into half guard. Good little hip move there. But looked like Leandro Ataides was trying to set up a Kimura, but good work by Muhammad Ali to get back up to his feet to end the first round.
Wonderful first round it's been. The bell's about to sound, and I've really enjoyed this first 5 minutes. 10 more to go.
overall, here's that catch from the leg kick where we just saw Muhammad Ali explode out and start throwing some heavy bombs. Not scared of the ground game at all, but then there's a nice little left hook.
Round two.
So perhaps a whole new ball game for Muhammad Ali to have to deal with now.
But that takedown at the end of the round just kind of leaves an impression in Ali's head that this fight can go to the ground at any minute.
Now he's hurt his leg. That left leg took an absolute hammer blow just to the outside of the knee. And he hobbled on it for a bit, and he's still a little bit tender on it.
He's a little weary, but he kind of shakes it off well and answers with a leg kick of his own. Ataides, nice and relaxed.
It's
nice
a very,
and loose.
Very nice sort of stalking shape he's got. Ataides as he comes forward. There's that left hook again.
Just trying to figure out the game of Ali and really just understand the distance and the timing that he's got, because the power can come out of nowhere just like that. I think it was a bit of a slip, but his timing's there with that right hand. Ali can let it go. Gives him a slight little inch, he'll sneak it in there. Yeah, I think that was a slip. I think he just kind of went for a kick and Ali stepped in at the right time.
There's that wide stance that Muhammad Ali has. Springy on his legs. Oh, he sent in a knee there and caught his knees wobbled. Oh, he's really wobbly. Why isn't Ataides chasing after him? Has he missed a trick there? Very, very cautious, the Brazilian.
Oh, he's giving him a lot of time to recover because he was on wobbly legs.
He's still looking shaky, Mitch, to me. Why is Ataides so hesitant?
He's giving him a chance to come back. He's giving him a long, that was like 30 seconds of recovery time.
He can't be toying with him, can he?
You would think so. You would hope that that is part of his game plan, that he's seeing something that we're not quite, you know, capable of understanding right now, because he just shook Ali with that nice straight shot.
Absolutely no doubt that Ali was in trouble for quite a considerable time there.
How could he not pull the trigger?
Baffles me. He can't be that fatigued at this stage. It can't be a question of just being too tired.
Or even possibly shooting for a takedown, which he told me he was going to do. But he seems to be perfectly content to stand on his feet and bang.
Well, he must be. He must feel very much in control. We shall leave it to him.
Ali completely seems to be recovered. He seems to have his wits about him. He's nice and light on his feet, moving around.
I do think he's still got a bit of trouble with that left leg, though, Mitch. He doesn't seem to put all the weight on there as he starts to skip around. But you pick up knocks during the course of a fight. It's only to be expected.
Yeah, he's definitely light and tender on that leg. A nice little left hook there, landed again.
Goes after that leg once more in a similar sort of place. Either way, it buckles the knee outside in, which is exactly what that previous kick did. And I think Ataides thinks he's fully in control here and can bide his time and finish this any way he wants. Will that be a big error of judgment?
Very patient. Very patient, relaxed striker, looking for his shots.
That lateral left hook from shoulder height to chin height was thrown with some beauty, but it missed entirely. Lucky for Muhammad Ali.
Action!
Oh, good right left. It was the left hand that landed from Ali. Just seeing a little bit of daylight for him to come back into this one. Has he been given too much time?
The accuracy is not there from Ali, but the power still is. You can almost feel the wind coming off of some of these strikes, even though they're, you know, almost a couple feet from the target, but they're still coming at a pretty fierce pace. Ataides is starting to march forward.
There's that kick again. That left leg, Muhammad Ali, is taking some punishment. Right on the outside, just above the knee.
But maybe he's not seeing the tenderness to that leg and how gingerly that, you know, Muhammad Ali is on. Because he's just kind of, you know?
It's a good point. He doesn't get the holistic view of things that we do. He's focused eye to eye.
You know, when Ataides has rushed in, you know, he's made that mistake before and he's gotten dropped. You know, so maybe he's just being a little bit more cautious, a little bit smarter fighter, trying to take this fighter in, fight into the deep water. And, beautiful!
Goodness me, I was just waiting for the bell to chime. And instead, it was Muhammad Ali's bell that got ringed.
Beautifully connects to the left side of his head. Superb knockout. With all those grappling credentials, you would not be surprised if this fight goes to the ground, but both fighters have been talking extensively about keeping it on the feet and trading shots.
Pasternak City's game plan here tonight is to draw Ataides into deep water. He believes the cardio isn't matching his, and if he can get Leandro out of the first round, the Brazilian will tire. Meanwhile, Ataides said he'll get Pasternak on the ground and sub him out via an armbar. It's Pasternak in the black shorts here in the southpaw stance.
Both fighters just kind of feeling each other out with the jab, trying to gauge that distance. Good movement, circling away from the power of the powerful Brazilian.
Looking for a counter right hand, the lead right of the southpaw, overhand right there from Pasternak. Drifts backwards now, looking to control center cage the pole. Ataides, you know, the first chance he gets to take down Pasternak, he'll go for it.
Big looping strikes coming off that lead hand of Pasternak. Very odd to see a lead overhand right, but he's throwing it.
High right roundhouse there from the Brazilian. Produced the knockout of the year in 2016, a flying knee knockout of Muhammad Ali. Can he repeat here tonight and get airborne? Fake there off the backhand from Pasternak, telegraphed the overhand right. Still a filling out process here in the opening round. Set for three. Ataides goes down the center corridor with the right hand and a short left hook, feints the right cross. Awkward angle on that punch there from the Brazilian, looks to cut off the cage.
Yeah, he's trying to step forward, cradle, cutting the distance off, kind of utilizing different footwork, showing some different looks for Pasternak to, you know, not quite get comfortable in the striking.
Ataides now trying to control center cage. Pasternak jabs his way in. He was in orthodox stance there. Goes back to his favorite southpaw stance.
You can see how Ataides, he goes in with the jab and he steps forward with the right as he's coming in, changing his footwork. We're seeing a lot of fighters nowadays alternate back and forth between southpaw and orthodox stances. It's that next level of striking.
Still a standing contest here, as we said earlier, both men very well versed and champions on the ground. And this one so far, a glorified kickboxing contest. Jab there from the Brazilian.
Yeah, but they're two different levels of Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu credentials. Ataides is a world champion, while Pasternak is just a regional Abu Dhabi.
Ataides, a 77% finishing rate. Pasternak, 58% finishing rate. Tries to thread that left cross down the center corridor. Good outside thigh kick from Pasternak, just above the knee to that common peroneal nerve. Jumping knee from Ataides! Our shadows of the Muhammad Ali knockout there in the first round from Leandro Ataides.
He loves to take flight, looking for the high flying. Not a lot of damage done there, but he's definitely showing these little bit of fanciness to his strikes. He's putting them out there.
The win against Ali was much needed for Leandro last year. It turned the tide in a three-fight losing streak. How he'd love to keep the wins going here tonight and knock out Pasternak. Pasternak did say yesterday he believes Ataides is most powerful in the first round.
Yeah, but that knockout of Muhammad Ali came late into the fight, so he reserved a lot of that power. So he's actually learning how to control his energy output so he can last longer into the fight.
Ataides switching stance now, and he catches Pasternak with a right out of southpaw. There's a bolo-style uppercut from Ataides. Quite a difference in camp between these two men. Ataides had a 12-week training camp. Pasternak, a 5-week camp. Outside leg kick from the pole. Both probing with the lead hands here. Makes it a little awkward when you're an Orthodox fighting a southpaw, and those lead hands do tend to clash up like that, Mitch.
Yeah, they do, but they're just kind of, you can just see them. They're just kind of finding their range, trying to really understand just how close and how far that is. You know, when you're a southpaw, you're used to fighting right-handed fighters. But when you're a right-handed fighter, Orthodox, you really don't get a lot of looks at southpaws.
Ataides has been known for explosive first rounds in the past. He's got four first round knockouts. Quickest was in 21 seconds over Ricardo Silva in Shooto. Is he going to launch a knee here just before the bell? Oh, counter right handed beauty there from Pasternak. Drifts off the cage, threads an overhand right. Switch a stance, and we go to the towels at the end of one.
Let's go back and take a look at some of the striking from Ataides. And that's, I think that's been the difference of the fight. You can see he lands that leaping jab, jumping in like a fencer, getting away from the counter left hook, or right hook, rather.
Second round. Fight!
Pasternak showing in the first. He is very capable with the counter punching. Ataides got airborne once with a flying knee. Fake there from Pasternak in his preferred southpaw stance again. Ataides is setting his right hand here, and he fires it off, Mitch.
You can start to see Pasternak starting to circle away from that right hand of Ataides. He's not trying to get backed up. You can see what Ataides is trying to do. He's trying to put Pasternak's back up against the cage so he can launch some of these flying strikes. But Pasternak needs to keep moving. He needs to keep circling out to that weaker side of Ataides.
Setting the right hand again, perhaps here Ataides. It's Pasternak who goes down the center. Both men launching the heavy artillery early on here in the second. Looping left hand there from Leandro Ataides.
You know, this was Pasternak's game plan. He wants to pull this fight into deeper water. So Ataides starts to get a bit fatigued, but releasing energy conservation from Ataides. He's not really putting everything into each one of these shots. He's landing shots, not really exerting a lot of energy, no takedown attempts. Like you said, Michael, just that constant forward pressure and landing with the strikes, but then getting out and evading the counter.
Pasternak, who was quite the revelation in Poland at the start of his career, went 11-0, an amazing streak in Europe before signing with one championship. Little jab there from Ataides. Still, we have a striking contest. There is no indication of either man looking to take this fight to the ground. Lunges, overreaches a little with that. Rear left hand is Pasternak. There's the counter from the pole, beautifully timed.
Ataides has trained with some of the top strikers in Brazil out there at Novo Leon. He trains with Jose Aldo, Henan Barão, just some of the top level strikers, and he's really learned a lot, and that's where he likes to keep things. He likes to keep things on his feet, and he's showing good head movement here. He really hasn't been like hit with a lot of shots from Pasternak. Pasternak's just out of range.
Now he's a five-time world BJJ champion and a gold medalist in the Copa do Mundo. Ataides has had only two wins by submission, five by knockout.
He prefers to entertain the crowd. That's definitely, you know, his game plan is to keep this feet, keep this fight on his feet and throw those hands.
Pasternak drifting towards his right, staying out of range of the right hand of Leandro Ataides. Ataides has shown already in this round he's got some pepper in that right hand.
You know, I'd like to see, you know, Ataides start throwing in some leg kicks, you know, start softening up that lead leg there of Pasternak, because he has suffered a leg injury in the past, but he showed so much determination and so much heart and spirit of a warrior by fighting through the second half of that fight with a nasty leg injury.
Pasternak almost shaving the beard there with that right hand to the chin of Ataides. Lots of concentration on these two martial artists. Outside leg kick, nice step across there from Pasternak.
So Pasternak's the one that decides to go after the legs. I like that. Mix things up a little bit. If they're only throwing one weapon, your opponent can get a lot more comfortable with knowing what's coming at them.
Despite what Pasternak told us yesterday, it doesn't look like Leandro Ataides is slowing down at all. In fact, he loads up that left hand again, throws it as an overhand. Good left hook there from Pasternak, then a little quarter turn off to his left, drifts back towards the right now.
Ataides is starting to create better angles. He's throwing punches and stepping off to the side, not being there for the straight counter.
Left hand down the tube from Pasternak. Left hook from Ataides. Didn't quite turn the knuckles in. Backs up the pole now. Jab from the Brazilian. Under a minute remaining. Second round of three. Wild uppercut there from Ataides.
Striking advantage has definitely got to be going to Ataides at this point. He's landing so many more strikes, consistent forward pressure, and he's just barely out of the way. The first big takedown of the fight.
We're on the canvas for the first time tonight. Ataides, top position here, half guard for the Brazilian. Back elbows from Pasternak, trying to attack the ear of Ataides. Now nice. Let's see who has the upper hand on the ground. Ataides just looking to smother Pasternak on the ground here, and Pasternak wants to control Ataides' posture and not allow the Brazilian to work those heavy hands in the ground and pound.
Nice way for Ataides to end the round on top, delivering a ground and pound. Stuck in the half guard. Very good. These are some of the hands. Look at that. He evaded the jab, came back with a left-right combination of his own. But the big story of that round was the takedown. Look at this. Double leg, shoots in underneath the punches.
Final
fight!
Ataides has got a really good game plan. He's conserving his energy well, in and out of strikes, evading damage, and he also landed that big takedown to end the round there in second.
It may be all for Michael Pasternak to do here in the third and final. Just under 5 minutes remaining in this contest. And Ataides switching starts, and he eats a nice left hand from the pole. Pasternak looks like he's got a little bit more gusto behind him. His corner is screaming to him, Michael, move, Michael, move. They don't want him to be flat-footed here, because when you're flat-footed, Ataides can tee off on you with the heavy hands.
You see that constant forward pressure, these lunging shots by Ataides, but he's mixing them up. He's showing different angles on every single one of his strikes.
Mitch, if you're in the corner of Pasternak, what are you telling him to do here?
He's got to soften up that lead leg. He's only thrown one leg kick the entire fight, and that actually landed quite successfully. He's got to keep consistently mixing up these combinations. And his left jab really isn't a jab. It's like this swinging, sweeping hook. He's got to throw these stinging jabs out there, because then he just throws that naked straight right, and Ataides is nowhere to be found.
Looping left hand again there from Ataides. With just over 3 minutes and 30 remaining, Michael Pasternak, the man from Kalisze in South Central Poland, needs to get to work. Jab from Ataides just keeping Pasternak at bay. Is it time for Pasternak to switch things up here? Maybe look for a takedown of his own. He's trying to change the recipe.
We'd love to see him try to shoot and be a little bit more aggressive. Right now he's starting to try things. He's trying to throw strikes, but Ataides has just got his head moving constantly, so a lot of these strikes are not landing clean. He's being aggressive in the third round, but he's not really increasing his significant strike advantage.
Back to southpaw stands for Pasternak, switches to orthodox corner, and telling him to switch. They're telling him to start throwing down. Looks for the outside leg kick, misses the target.
See, it's hard to throw a kick like that when you don't set it up with some punches behind it. The footwork of Ataides has been very slick all night. Constant movement, his head is never in the same spot. Every time he throws a punch, he leans to the left or right to evade the counter strikes.
Ooh, winning back fist there from Ataides, just caught the neck of Pasternak.
I like that look. He faked a roundhouse kick, came around with a spinning back fist.
Oh. Ataides may have knocked out Muhammad Ali last time, and he started to do a bit of an Ali shuffle then. Confidence oozing on Leandro Ataides, who, contrary to what Pasternak thought yesterday, has not tired out. Beautiful evasion there and retaliation from Ataides.
See, he strikes and his head is constantly moving, Michael.
Controlling center cage. It may be desperation times now for Michael Pasternak of Poland. Time becomes Pasternak's enemy.
Got a minute and 45 to start putting the hurt on. He's got to continue to push forward. Can't let Ataides control the center of the cage.
Ataides just looking to walk him down. Pasternak takes a little stroll, resets himself. fires the left cross down the tube. Oh, Ataides tags him on the jaw. Pasternak nodded at him and said, yep, you got me with that one. Beautiful pork right hand there. Ataides just oozing confidence here in the final round. Showboating a little. Good right hand. High left roundhouse kick from Ataides. He has out kickboxed Pasternak here tonight.
Like outboxed him here tonight. He's definitely just thrown a variety of punches that have landed clean. And Pasternak really doesn't have an answer for the striking of Ataides. He attempted the flying knee again. That seems to be his favorite strike. Constantly moving heads, never in the same spot. Look at that. Moving, but dodging left and right, stepping in, nice lands. He lands the leg kick. I'd like to see more of that from Ataides.
A beautiful right hand, smack bang to the kisser there from Leandro Ataides. Pasternak has taken some solid shots to the jaw in this closing round. 20 seconds remaining now. Looks for a takedown Pasternak, but it's far too little too late from the pole. Something he should have tried to employ earlier, Mitch.
Yeah, nice straight right hand lands by Ataides, shaking the hand around, ready to let it go.
Oh, and he staggers him with the right hand just before the bell and a flying knee. Leandro Ataides bringing it home strongly. The Brazilian on fire. Time. What a way to end for Leandro Ataides. He pumps his fists into the air.
There's that fake roundhouse attempt, lands the spinny back fist.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Leandro Ataides.
Outside leg kicks traded by both men. Ataides center cage. Big dash on the outside. Could we get a contender for the GoDaddy knockout of the night here? It's most likely. Big Dash fires the right hand down the tube.
I'm not liking how Leandro's leaning back with that, as you can kind of see him faint, the Big Dash fainting in. And Leandro's kind of leaning back with his chin up in the air. He's got to be careful with that. Big Dash might come straight down the middle. He's also throwing those wheel kicks real well.
Ataides has been known to fly, to get airborne with those lunging knees. Scooping shot there from Ataides, nowhere near the target, goes to the inside lower leg. Big Dash looking very focused, very calm. Moving well, the balls of his feet, the Russian.
Andrew's pushing forward, backing up Big Dash up against the cage. Big Dash starts to circle out. Leandro's fainting. Ooh, calf kick.
Still a filling out process by both of these men. Ataides still controlling center cage. Look at them staring each other down, analyzing each other's technique and their movement, the angles.
I do like how Ataides is changing levels. You can see that nice little pop that he's doing, a little squat, just kind of threatening the takedown a little bit. Let's see him shoot in, though, a little bit. Throw some punches, going for a double leg test. Ooh.
Counter overhand right there from Big Dash came close. And Ataides still controlling center cage, forcing the Russian to the outside. Some cagey movement here from Vitaly. Big Dash looks for a counter overhand right off the leg kick.
See the hush kind of fall over the crowd. Everybody's waiting for one big shot to come flying in.
One championship needed to have only have sold the edge of the seats for this one, because everyone here in Jakarta is on the edge of their seats.
They paid for the whole seat, but they don't need it tonight.
Ataides cocking that left hand in southpaw stance right now. The Brazilian has got some heavy leather. And Big Dash saying, come on, let's see what you've got. Challenging Ataides to come forward.
Big Dash is waiting for the counter strike. He wants Ataides to come rushing in so he can counter. But that's what Ataides just did.
Big Dash has only lost when he lost the world title to Ong Lan Sang. How he'd love a trilogy match with Ong La in Yangon. Ataides edges forward in orthodox stance now. He has been switching all round.
His hands are real low, but he's keeping that right hand near his chin, but that left hand is coming from different angles. You can see him raise it up really fast and kind of split in the guard of Bigdash.
Both these athletes still in first gear. Thought about a counter overhand right there. Did Bigdash fakes the back kick and resets.
Like to see Leandro go back to that leg kick. That calf kick worked really well. Like to see him go back to it again. Slow down the movement of Bigdash. Get him stationary.
We've seen Bigdash drift into the right hand of Ataides. There he goes again, drifting off to his left into Ataides' right, showing no respect for the power hand of the Brazilian. Inside leg kick, nicely placed there from Vitaly Bigdash. Jab two from Ataides. Outside leg kick from the Brazilian. Still a filling up process, do you feel here, Mitch?
I think so. I think they're just trying to get a read on each other, understand the distance and timing, but especially with Ataides changing back and forth between southpaw and orthodox, it's hard for Bigdash to get a read on him. But then Bigdash is also kind of, you know, gyrating his hand movements, kind of not giving Leandro exactly the taste that he's looking for.
Good check of the low kick. Double check there from Ataides. Jab two from the Brazilian, still in center cage, as it has been all round. With Bigdash on the outside, there was a nice high check from Ataides.
This is a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion checking leg kicks, Michael. That is impressive.
His striking has improved out of sight over the last 12 to 18 months, Ataides. He's going to kick there from Bigdash.
He's incredibly relaxed and comfortable in there. He's marching forward, hands are down, pushing the pace, creating a lot of the action here.
Oh, he shot in for a double leg right on the bell. Ataides, we go to town.
Round two. Choke.
Second round of action. Ataides and Bigdash.
Bigdash hasn't gotten the respect of Leandro. He hasn't even put his hands up yet.
Spinning back fist there from Ataides. What does concern me about Leandro, though, he is carrying his hands very low. His weight is forward, and his chin is hanging out there, Mitch.
Yeah, but that's kind of his style. I would like to see the chin get tucked. The hands down, you know, that's okay, but because he's coming from different angles. But you can see, you know, whatever hand he's, you know, his rear hand, it does come up near his chin. And he's delivering some awkward shots with that lead hand. So you can't really quite see where they're coming from. If you got a high guard, like Bigdash does, you can see where those punches are coming straight at you. But when it's down, it comes from odd angles.
Just take a look, folks, at the legs of the feet of Ataides and count how many times he switches stance already. And we're just about a minute down in this second round. He must have switched at least 8 times. Which is he more comfortable in, do you feel, the southpaw or the orthodox stance, Mitch?
Pretty sure he's an orthodox athlete, but you know, he seems very comfortable out of that southpaw stance. And he's moving around very well, and it's giving another wheel kick coming from Bigdash, but it's giving Bigdash some problems. He's not able to initiate anything. He's waiting for Leandro to come at him, and then he's going back and attacks himself.
So when we say southpaw, it's as now with right foot forward, left hand being the power hand. When we say orthodox, it's as now with the left foot forward, the right hand being the power hand. So you'll see Ataides constantly switch between the two to confound Bigdash. Never let Bigdash know where the power is coming from. And it means that Bigdash has to constantly adjust also, Mitch.
Very true. And you can see that by Leandro cutting the angles of where Bigdash is going. So if Bigdash starts to circle to the left, you can see him switch stances so that he goes into his right hand. Once Bigdash starts to circle to the right, Leandro switches back to southpaw so that Bigdash is circling into his power side again.
BJJ world champion putting on some fantastic strike. Oh, he turns it! A beautiful counter right hand, smack bang on the kisser. And Bigdash does a quick count of his take.
I like the acknowledgement they both had. Bigdash goes, yep, you got me. And Leandro goes, yeah, I got you.
Mitch, do you feel these two men, given the high stakes that are up here tonight, are holding back a little too much?
Now, I don't think Leandro's holding back. He's picking his shots very carefully. Bigdash seems a bit hesitant. He's not really pushing forward with this sort of linear, aggressive, straight-on kickboxing style that we've seen from him in the past. He's letting Leandro control the center, back him up against the cage, and the way Leandro's changing stances, very the way that he's circling, just as Leandro misses a big knee there, Leandro's feeling very confident at this point.
We did see Leandro shooting for a double leg in the final second of the opening round, but no signs of a takedown attempt here in the second round.
I don't think he needs to. I think he's doing a very good job on his feet. And I could say this right as Bigdash unloads a huge shot, but see how he changed to southpaw again as Bigdash was circling to the right. So you can see that Bigdash starts to circle into the power. Once Bigdash starts to move to the left, Leandro goes back orthodox.
Bigdash went for a liver shot, then threw a high left roundhouse, but pulled it back halfway. 1 minute 20 remains, second round of action. Been some good signs, some good glimpses from Leandro Ataides.
Good check.
I just feel that Bigdash hasn't found the flow, hasn't found the rhythm. It's lining up the one big punch, but not accompanying it by setting up with a jab or the leg kicks or a hook first.
He's not getting punched, and that's what he needs to do. He needs to start putting pressure on Leandro.
And he's not initiating Mitch. He's allowing Leandro to initiate most of the attacks here. And Mitch, I've got to ask you, the expert, the question, why? Why is Bigdash playing this game? Why is he not initiating that?
Just went up there with a big high kick. You know, I can't say why. Maybe it's because he's not feeling himself. Maybe he's trying to be strategic, trying to lure Ataides into something that Leandro's open to with his hands down, his chin up in the air, and he's able to hit him. But the confidence and the swagger coming off Ataides right now is very impressive. Allah is probably watching this very intently, breaking him down on a different level.
Getting back fist there from Ataides. Ataides has controlled the center of the cage the entire contest so far. In the third round, which is where we're going to go very soon, we've got to see Bigdash do something different. We've got to see the Russian change it up, Mitch.
He has very aggressive punching combinations, but you can see beautifully done. Look at that movement from Ataides. Out of the way, lands a shot.
Final round.
Okay, is Bigdash going to go to the outside again? Will he try and stamp his authority in Shinsuke?
See, just now he went first. He's starting to move forward. He's starting to throw the combinations. That's what Bigdash is known for.
This is a little more like it from Vitaly. Bigdash, oh, jumping knee! Ataides, you know he's planted opponents like trees with that flying knee before. Jab from Bigdash, not giving up center cage so easily now. Hook from Bigdash. High on the balls of his feet, counter overhand right from the Russian.
Leandro's head movement is pretty slick right now. I know his chin's up, his hands are down a little bit when he's drifting back, but his head is nowhere to be found.
The headache maker from Vitaly Bigdash.
But his hand was up, Leandro blocked that.
And again, we get this situation of a switch stance. Leandro Ataides controlling center cage, pressing Vitaly Bigdash to the outside. Bigdash counter right hand down the center. Inside leg kick was a nice one. Jab from Ataides. Jab two from Bigdash. Last time we saw Bigdash in action, he did hang back and he was disappointed by the decision that was given to him, Mitch. Is he making the same mistake here? Is he holding back too much?
I mean, it's obvious that he might be holding back a little bit now. He's not pushing forward the way he normally does. But now we're starting to see in the third round, he's starting to become more active. He's throwing more strikes and initiating attacks.
Do you think he's waiting to go kleptomaniac and steal the round in the final minute and a half?
I mean, he might be trying to do that, but I mean, this is not a championship match. This is not five rounds. He's got less than 3 minutes to put a huge punctuation in this round and in the match.
And more than that, there's so much at stake. It's not a world championship match, but a world championship spot is up for grabs.
But right now, but we gotta pay attention to Leandro. I think it's more the fact that Leandro is confusing Bigdash rather than Bigdash holding back. The constant switching of the stances, the incredibly relaxed attitude from Ataides.
Oh, he turned it! Here comes Leandro! He chooses to take it down! Can he finish it now? Bigdash is hurt! The ground and pound! The monstrous ground and pound! The monster battle!
again. Big Superman punch. Wobbled Bigdash. Leandro, sensing the end was in sight, goes for the takedown, gets on top, and starts raining down the ground and pound. Number one contender, Leandro Ataides.
Number one indeed, number one with a stunner.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.